welcome back to the channel. On today's episode, we got a new product into the shop from a company called MJJC, and it's the Foam Cannon Pro model. Now, MJJC reached out to me recently, and they're like, Jeremy, we'd like you to consider reviewing our product. Now, I'm really particular about the products I bring in here, so I did my homework. I agreed to let them send it out, and I'll take a look at it. And once I looked at it, then I agreed that I'll go ahead and do a review. But no money changed hands, and they're not going to get to see the review until you get to see the review. So it's going to be my personal opinion of this tool. All right, so without any further delay, let's get into it and see what it has to offer. All right, so the MJJC Foam Cannon. Let's start by looking at the bottle. It's got these nice finger grooves, which makes it kind of really easy to turn on and off and kind of get some extra torque on it, which I think is nice. So the bottle itself, it's made out of kind of like a sports drink type material. Man, it's hard. There's no way you're gonna bust this up. If you dropped it from 5'6", even higher, no problem on this one. Now, also it's got that conical shape to it, which is really nice. It's just not gonna tip over. That's huge, because some of the foam cannons in the past, they were tall and skinny. They toppled over, man. None of us enjoyed it. We figured out ways to make it work. But man, now that it's larger on the bottom, skinnier on the top, that's gonna be great. On the side, we have a graduated measurement system that starts with 500 milliliters and goes all the way up to 1,000, enabling us to help measure those dilution ratios. Also, one thing I like about this that I haven't seen on other foam cannon models, it has a nice large mouth on it. Very big. So what that means is, man, you're not trying to like thread some skinny little thing on there hoping you don't misthread it and rip it to bits. I mean, literally, it goes on, easy to turn on and off. I mean, it's not like a finesseful song and dance to get the thing on. I like that. I want it to be easy. So I want to just grab it, screw the thing right on without any questions. I don't want to struggle with that, and I don't want you guys struggling with it either. All right, so let's move on up to the actual tool itself, the spray nozzle. One thing right off the bat that I noticed that's kind of neat is it's got this stainless steel marble on the end. It actually has a hole in it. Now, what this enables it to do is no matter which way I point the gun, the gravity is going to hold that heavy marble down, and it's going to want to draw the liquid from the lowest point in the container, which is really neat. So as I'm laying it down on its side, you know, the marble's laying down here on the bottom and it's drawing material. So it's moving around constantly so that I can get all the material out of there. And we want to use it all. I mean, this stuff isn't cheap, and I don't want to be dumping an ounce or two of it out after every time. So that's kind of good. So we also got this really nice soft silicone tube, really flexible. Let's move on up now. Like I said before, the cap, it's very hard plastic. It's not gonna break, and it has good threads on it, so we're not babying those threads. So let's move on up. We got all brass internals here. Let's start with the quick disconnect. So each of these come, you order it, you pick which type of pressure washer you have, and they've made an effort so that you can put a different piece on for every different pressure washer so that it'll screw on to your standard hose that comes with the machine. Now, everybody that's been following the channel, most of us have like a custom pressure washer system with a gun with a quarter inch quick disconnect. So that's the one we want. And this is nice. It's brass, stainless steel end, really, really high quality, well built. And inside here, you can see that there's the orifice in there is all brass internals. And the screw fitting here that requires no silicone tape is nice too. So once you put the fitting on, just screw it together. And I've had no leaks. I've already been testing this thing a little bit, and I have no leaks whatsoever, which is great. Now we're up to the mixture valve. Really easy to use, easy to turn. And we get good action out of this, and we're gonna put that to the test here in a minute. Let's move around to the front of the gun. Some improvements that they've made on this. Now, not only do we have the ability to change the width of the fan by the normal twist and turn, and the device opens and closes, now with this model, we can turn it 360 degrees and get full action on it, whether we wanna do a horizontal fan or a vertical fan, which is a nice addition. I feel like a modern foam cannon, it better have all these things, man, or it's just not staying with the times. That's just a fact. All right, so again, this is all made out of that hard, you know, exercise water bottle type material. It seems really tough. I mean, now guys, all of our stuff, man, we're not throwing it around. None of this stuff is cheap. So this is not your $20 Amazon model. At the time of the filming, this was $59. So I don't know what it'll be if and when you see this video, but so this isn't exactly super dirt cheap, but it's a little bit more affordable than some of the other ones that I've reviewed in the past, like the MTM foam cannon. So just keep in mind, it's going to be a little bit more affordable than that. And I want to see the results of this to see if that affordability still provides us with that quality that we all need. And that's the bottom line. Is this thing going to kick some butt out there on the panel? Let's go see. Yeah. So we put the MJJC foam cannon pro to the test, and when I was laying down the foam on the side of that truck, I was thinking to myself, man, this is putting down some good foam. I'm really, really impressed with it. Nice, precise, clear lanes. Really easy to adjust. As soon as I turned it on, I just took a half a second, got my fan right. I run the mixture valve wide open. I figure, man, you know what? At wide open, we could easily do a large vehicle SUV. So I'm not worried about it, but if you wanted to conserve some material, you could definitely turn it down and get it to go a lot longer, just probably with a little less foam. So man, the economy on it was awesome. And I keep coming back to this bottle. Man, really well made. That ball bearing marble on the bottom that keeps it sucked. When I was finished, there was nothing left in it. It was bone dry, which is kind of cool. And these threads, there, man, it's done. No special technique, man. All right, so that's pretty much all I got to say about the foam cannon. But, you know, I put it to the test. I showed you. But what really matters is, what do you guys think? So let me know down below what you thought about it. And consider hitting that like button. Guys, that really helps. It supports the channel, moves me up in the rankings so other people get to see it. And it gets me motivated to come out here and put out some more videos. Another thing, that subscribe button, man, join the family, join the team. And hit that subscribe button, turn on the bell so you don't miss any of our future videos. I sure appreciate all your guys' support. I really do. The channel's growing. I'm excited and try to keep stepping it up little by little. All right. And like every other product that I like, man, that's a good product right there. I'll see you on the next one. Yeah.